Hello, dear students. Today I am telling you about the vertebrates. Vertebrates are the animals. There is a narration that all the vertebrates are the chordates, but all chordates are not the vertebrates. If you talk about that, chordates has three characteristic features. That number one is the dorsal tubular nerve cord, number two is notochord, and number three is postanal tail. In vertebrates, all these characteristic features of chordates are modified into number one, dorsal tubular nerve cord modified in the form of spinal cord, notochord modified in the form of vertebrates, and postanal tail is somewhat disappeared. Now students, due to the modification of this notochord into vertebral columns, these animals are characterized as vertebrates. Under to these vertebrates, some school of thoughts think about that vertebrata is a separate subphylum, and some are considering it as a phylum. If we talk about that, in terms of the bilateral symmetry means if you just, this is a part of this one, if you just to cut to this plane, so this plane will be cut out into two similar halves. That means that is the example of bilateral symmetry. In another terms, if you talk about that this bilateral symmetry is also a characteristic feature of these chordates. Under to this, on the basis of embryonic developments, these bilateral symmetry animals are subdivided into protostomes and deuterostomes. If the blastopore changes into mouth at first, then the animals are categorized as protostomes. But whenever this blastopore changes into anus, then this is considered as deuterostomes. Echinodermates onward, all the chordates comes under to these deuterostomes. And these echinoderms are the marine animals. They are the example of the invertebrates. They has the pentarytal symmetry and other things. But the chordates, in case of the chordates, the most diverse group of the chordates is Pisces, that is a superclass. In the coming lectures, I will tell you more little bit about that. So I think I summarized the what is vertebrates and why all the vertebrates are called chordates, because the chordates has two parts, protochordates and higher chordates. In higher chordate, vertebrates are coming, protostomes and deuterostomes, as well as somewhat features of the echinodermates. Thank you.